Hi friends, today we are going to see what are the effect of truncation on a special format of number which we use for representing a negative number. Okay, so the format that we are considering today is sign and magnitude. So just to recall that we are going to use sign and magnitude representation of a negative number. Now, just for your recall purpose, okay, we will just revisit that what is this sign and magnitude number. Okay, so if suppose I have a -7/8 number, then I will represent first its magnitude, okay, and I will give one bit for representing the sign. As we know that we are going to represent b1 bits to right of the binary point, and we are going to use one bit to the left of the binary point. Correct? So we have one bit on the left of the binary point, and we have the rest b1 bits on the right of the binary point. And this one bit that I will be using as a sign bit. Okay, so this is what the normal sign and magnitude representation is all about. Now 7/8, its magnitude is given by 0.111. If you will evaluate, it will be like this: 1/2 plus 1/4 plus 1/8. Correct? So I will have by 8 in the denominator, then here it will be 8 fours or 2 fours are 8 plus 4 twos are 8 plus 1. So that will give me 7/8. Okay, that is a magnitude. So B1 bits, how many bits I'm representing? I'm representing 3 bits. Okay. To represent, so my B1 over in this case, B1 is how much? 3 bits. Okay, and one bit which is left of the bit, which is this, we will be using this bit to represent the sign. If it is 0, the sign bit is, the number is positive. If it is 1, then the number is negative. Always remember, this 0 means positive number, this is 1 means negative number. Okay, so -7/8 will be represented as 1.111. correct? This bit indicates that the number is negative, and 111 represent that this is 7/8. Understood? So now I have understood that if I wanted to represent a b1 bit, then I want one bit dedicatedly using for sign. So this is just a recall of sign and magnitude, how to represent a sign and magnitude number. Let us go ahead and see that what are the effect of truncation on this type of format. Let us take a number. I'll take a number -11/16, okay, which is in fraction I can write it as -0.6875 in decimal. Okay, now I wanted to find its binary equivalence. So the binary equivalence of this number is, okay, for the magnitude I'll write first. So I will write with different color. So, or we will write it like this. This is only the magnitude. The magnitude of the number is 0.101100. So how many total bits? So B1 is nothing but 6 bits. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm using 6 bits. Now I need to inculcate the sign. So for the sign part, I will have the first digit to be 1 and rest follows the magnitude. So like this, I'll write like this. This is my sign bit. Why it will be 1? It will be 1 because the number is negative. If the number would be positive, I would have written this to be 0, and if this is 0, this will represent the normal magnitude. Combining them both, minus 0.6875 to the base 10 is represented as 1.101100 to the base 2. In which form? This is in the sign and magnitude form. Okay, so that is how I am representing a number. Now B1 is how many? 6 bits. Okay, now I'm using 6 bits B1. Let us truncate. And when I truncate again the two last digits. So these digits are being truncated. When I truncate these two numbers, what is going to happen? Okay, my new B will be, so now my B is how many bits? 4 bits. Okay, I have a 4 bit resistor. I need to fit that into 4 bits. Now my new number, which I called it as now, which will be 1.1011. Okay, this is what? Okay, this number which we have seen over here is my X, correct? So this number is my X, right? 11 by 16 or minus 0.6875 is my X number. Now I have to go for my QX number, which will be occurring after truncating the two digits. Now last two digits I have truncated, and the last two digits were 0, 0. Okay, so what effect does that truncation would have put? Okay, so what will be the magnitude? Now let us only consider the magnitude without considering this bit. So only considering the magnitude, this will be 1/2, 1/8, 1/16, isn't it? When I add them together, this total summation will be 11/16. Because this is minus, because this is 1, I need to write minus 1. So my Q of X will be equal to 11/16 because of this 3 guys, and it will be minus 11/16 only because there is 1 in the on the left hand side of the number. Okay, so this is again minus 0.6875. okay, now this is minus 0.6875, which is Q of X. What will be the error? So error E of T, which is equal to Q of X minus X, correct? So what is Q of X? Q of X is, so E of T, which is equal to Q of X is minus 0.6875, and X is also minus of minus 0.6875. So what is happening? This is becoming 0. So E of T is 0 in this case. So what I did, I removed all zeros. When I truncate in the number which is having sign and magnitude, if I truncate all zeros, then there will be no effect on a sign magnitude number and the error will be 0. Now let us consider, if suppose I have another number, okay, if I have another number which I consider is minus 0.7343 75. Let us consider this to be my number, which is nothing but minus 47/64. Okay, so it's binary. This is my decimal equivalence. Now for binary equivalence, I need to put 1 because this is negative, then point, and the binary magnitude of that number is 10 1111. Again, here B1 is 6 bits, correct? I need to truncate, so I will truncate this 2 bits. So when I truncate this 2 bits, now my new number, now this is my X, this is my X, okay, X is 0.734375. now I'm truncating the number, and the new number, which is Q of X, will be equal to something dash, because I wanted in the decimal equivalence. So the number given is 1 point, okay, 1011, right? So yeah, right, so this is B bits, which is equal to 4 bits. Okay, now what will be the exact number? Okay, so the exact number of 1011 we have just seen, it is minus, okay, 11/16. Minus is coming because this is 1, this magnitude corresponds to 11/16. You can check it out. and this corresponds to 0.6875 with a minus sign. So now my number that I have achieved is minus 11.16. So let us see what is the error. So error E of t will be Q of x minus x, which is equal to Q of x is minus 11.16 or minus 0.6875, minus of minus plus 0.734375. okay, this is because I have truncated two bits and which are one, okay, both are one. Okay, so now the effect has been tremendous. So you can see that the error will be positive because Q of x is negative but smaller compared to x. Okay, so what has happened? Q of x magnitude decreased. Okay, the Q of x magnitude decreased in the sign and magnitude format. That means when you truncate a number in a sign and magnitude format, the value of Q of x will be decreased. Okay, as same as that of positive numbers, but here we are decreasing the negative numbers. Okay, what is happening? As we are going more and more in the negative side, because Q of x is smaller as compared to x, sorry, Q of x is smaller as compared to x, but both are negative, error will always be positive. Okay, so here the subtraction will produce a positive error of 0.046875. I have purposefully kept it a longer length, E of t, which is positive. Okay, so what is happening when you are removing maximum number of ones, or when you are truncating from the number that are maximum number of ones, then the error becomes positive. So what is the minimum error? That is zero. What is the maximum error? Which is positive now. Okay, so the error in sign magnitude form is bounded between 0 to a positive value of 2 raised to minus b minus 2 raised to minus b1. Okay, 2 raised to minus b minus 2 raised to minus b1 is the bound on a positive number. We have surely seen that there is when you remove maximum number of zeros, then there will be no error. That is the minimum limit. And if you remove maximum number of ones, the error will be maximum. But in this case, it is positive. That's why the minimum range will be zero and maximum range will be 2 raised to minus b minus 2 raised to minus b. So this is the effect, or this is the error when you truncate a sign and magnitude number. I hope you have understood what I mean by truncating a sign and magnitude number and how does it affects. Thank you.